Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to 9th Ashrami Bangladesh International Conference. I'm Dr. Najmul Huda Shetu, presenting my first free paper sessions on knee deformity corrected by Elizarov method. Introduction: knee deformity are genu varum, genu valgum, fixed flexion deformity, knee flexion contracture, etc. Most common causes are congenital, traumatic, and infective. These deformities can be treated by Elizarov method. Basic principle of Elizarov method is law of tension, stress, compression, destruction, hysteresis of bone and soft tissue. Destruction hysteresis generates new bone and soft tissue under gradual destruction. Elizarov technique, which allows flexibility and adjustment at one or more levels for correction of multi-directional, multi-planar, and multi-level axial deformities, is superior to other conventional method. Materials and method: number of patients 6, male 3, male female 3, mean age 21 years, place of operation Nitor and in private hospital, time of operation March to September 2020. Knee deformities mainly varus, valgus, fixed flexion deformity, flexion contracture of the knee joint, recurvatum, etc. Modalities of treatment.
Recording in progress.
Commonly we use the treatment methodology: physiotherapy, spleen test, corrective device, capsulotomy, corrective plaster cast, traction, etc. Associated problems: limb length discrepancy, ugly scar with skin contracture, muscle contracture, infection, nerve injury, stiffness, and joint and stiffness of the joint, etc. Some important terminologies regarding knee deformity correction: mechanical axis, anatomical axis, femoral shaft axis, tibial shaft axis, cura, joint line, congruence angle, osteotomy, and its role. Some pictures regarding cura. Before correction of the deformity, we must know the appropriate location of the cura. Without location of cura, deformity correction is not possible. And it's osteotomy rule. Rule one, we know osteotomy line and angulation correction axis and cura are on the same line. That is rule one. Then mechanical axis will be perfectly corrected. Bone is will be angulated at the end of the correction. Rule two: when the angulation correction axis and cura are at the same level, osteotomy is at different level. The axis will realign by angulation and translation at the osteotomy site. Rule three: osteotomy and angulation correction axis are at the level above or below the cura, translation deformity will result. Some case illustration: 24 years male, male united distal femur with right genu varus deformity. Look, and before operation and after operation, you can see here. And this is the patient, 19 years male, valgus deformity bilateral, and one is corrected. And you can see here then before correction and after correction. And this is the female, 13 years female patient, valgus deformity traumatic, right knee, and corrected. Before correction and after correction, you can see. And 9 years girl, post-traumatic fixed flexion deformity of the right knee, ankylosed at 90 degree and varus deformity of the left knee. And gradually corrected. After the correction, you can see here. And before operation and after operation, you can see here. And this is a 38 years old female, flexion contracture of bilateral knee. She got her new life after 20 years of years by the Elizarov method. You can see here. When she came to me by this way, and after operation, she got the treatment and And next, 19 years male, and she, you can see here, before operation, and after operation, results. In one case has knee stiffness. All patients are now able to ambulate independently and carry out their daily routine activities. Still now there is no recurrence. Pin tract infection was common complication resolved by oral antibiotics, regular dressing, no intraoperative or postoperative neurovascular injury or nerve palsy. Conclusion. The Elizarov method is minimally invasive procedure. Diabetic infection with or without soft tissue coverage, where other methods of correction are not possible, then Elizarov method is the only choice. No bone graft is needed. Pre-operative patient counseling is very much important to get the best result of Elizarov method when patient compliance is good. With our director, sir, and our mentor, Professor Mofakkar Bari, and our Kurgan colleagues, thank you all. Thank you very much. Next time.
This meeting is being misspelling double and
asal bilang mana?
A S I S I
Sorry, sir. My question is different.
No, single case. I am coming to your question. And it is it totally depends upon the condition of the patient. Patient age, patient comorbidity and other factors over there. But usually, we 6 to 8 months is the time for correction of the deformity.
Can I ask another question, please?
Yes, sir.
6 to 8 months is a long period of time.
It's very much important. After the removal of the fixator, you must follow the physiotherapy, follow the postoperative management. Patient should encourage the movement, and if you think you also get the help of physiotherapist, and gradually then after the in case of knee contracture, after removal of fixator, you apply the brace for 2 months, and by this time you always encourage him to do the flexion and extension exercise. Then, and gradually, patient when feels comfortably, then you remove the brace and advise him to do the normal work. Thank you. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. I have one patient also in this presentation. There is a case that is already ankylosed for the infection, or then we do the knee in functional position of the position in we accept the arthrodesis and in functional position.
If
there is a chance of quadricepsplasty in case of if there is any joint space, we can see in a radiography radiologically, then we take the chance for quadricepsplasty, that is Judas quadricepsplasty. In case of if there is no infection, no other then we do the take the chance the Judas quadricepsplasty.
Thank you, Shetul sir, for your nice presentation. I have a question. In case of permanent stiffness of the knee joint, you show one case have developed the stiffness of the knee joint.
Yes.
In this case, do you have any plan for total knee replacement?
Thank you, sir. Total knee replacement, if there is a quadriceps mechanism is intact and if there is no infection, then she can take the chance of a total knee replacement. Thank
you. You have corrected the deformity, that's okay, you have corrected the deformity, but considering the age of the patient, if patient is, he has shown the most of the cases, 18, 20, 25, 30 cases, do you suggest for that the knee replacement, or you can go for Judas quadricepsplasty or modified Judas quadricepsplasty, considering the age of the patient, when you are getting knee stiffness after correction of the deformity, varus or valgus? That is the question, okay? Next. Oh, yes. Hey, moderator, koi? Dhanveer, jao here, you have to announce next case.
Assalamu alaikum and very good morning. I am Dr. Mohammad Saidul Islam, working as junior consultant, Pushta Medical College Hospital. Welcome to this 9th International Ashami Conference in Bangladesh. I am honored to be here because this is my first presentation in international conference. It's my great opportunity to present or to share my experience and my knowledge to all. Now going to my main discussion. Evaluation of result of Eliezer of external fixation in evaluation of result of Eliezer of external fixation in open segmental tibial shaft fracture in adult. You know that there is a dedicated Eliezer of TM in Pushta Medical College Hospital, including two Kurgan fellow, Dr. Arifuzzaman and Dr. Moni. We have learned a lot from them. These are Eliezer of TM. Now, tibial diaphyseal fracture is the most common long bone fracture, but open tibial segmental diaphyseal fracture is not so common. Always it associated with the severe soft tissue injury due to high velocity trauma and long-term complication like non-union, malunion, and the osteomyelitis is a common complication. There are a lot of modality to treat the segmental tibial fracture, internal fixation, external fixation, intermedullary or extramedullary fixation, uniplanar or multiplanar fixation, and hybrid fixation. As an orthopedic surgeon, we choose the Eliezerov technique for this segmental fracture. Why we choose the Eliezerov technique? Because this is universal, dynamic, and permits immediate axial loading. And it is percutaneous and very, very minimally invasive technique, not hampered the soft tissue again. And tiny bone fragment can be fixed. No worry about the working length or hardware dynamics. It induces increased blood supply, thereby promote angiogenesis and histogenesis. We operated 18 patients, 14 are male and 4 are female, within 7 to 14 days following admission. Fixation and fracture reduction are done under Siam guidance, mean frame time 5 to 8 months, and frame removed under analgesia after bony union. My first case, the patient Shubhro, 32 years old male. This is a segmental fracture, and the intercalary segment is very short and it is rotator deformity present here. At first we spanning the fracture side, then gradually reduction done. this is another X-ray, and after reduction, this is the last X-ray, and this is the picture of the Shubhro, and after union, after 6 months following fracture, the range of knee movement and ankle movement is okay. And after removal of frame. Second case is a long intercalary segment, and is displaced more, and it is intercalary segment overlap on distal and proximal segment. Under same guidance, gradually reduction done. This is the post-operative film, and after union, after removal of the frame. Another case. Result. All the fracture united with acceptable serrated and coronal parameter. A patient are followed up for 6 to 12 months after frame removal. No refracture is documented. Follow-up of patient with team is going on. Take-home message. Respect nature, respect biology. We can control given treatment at any point of follow-up. Elizaro give tension in oil, but reduce tension of surgeon. This is an orthopedic wall in our KMC. Thank you.
Thank you very much. It was a great presentation. Now I would like to request our learned audience and respected teachers. It is the time for question and answer session. If you have any question, you can ask. Our learned audience, please. If you have any question, you can ask. If you don't have any questions, then we can proceed to our next presenter.
I have one question. In the last slide that you have shown, one of your cases, last slide, you have corrected the segmental bone fracture with open, but do you think that the axis, mechanical axis and the anatomical axis in the tibia is in the proper? You can show the last slide.
It to slide the button.
Last slide. Here I go. So, look. You see it. So,
this is injury film, sir, and.
Probably. So this is your final, okay? This is your final.
Yes, sir.
If you draw the line, anatomical axis and the mechanical axis, do you think that in AP and lateral it's okay? Is there any angulation or not?
Yes.
This is acceptable?
Some degree of angulation.
Angulation. If you draw a line from your three fragments, proximal, middle, and last. If you draw the axis of the anatomical and the lateral, do you think there is a angulation deviation?
Yes.
Yes. So this is acceptable or not?
Acceptable.
Thank you very much. Now, it's the time for the next presenter. Now, I would like to request Dr. Arun Kumar Sarkar. Dr. Arun Kumar Sarkar, and the topic is the Elizarov Miracle in Skeletal Biology, The Magic of Elizarov Philosophy from Kurgan to Bangladesh. Dr. Arun Kumar Sarkar, Assistant Professor, NITOR. Dr. Arun Kumar Sarkar.
It's a very, very good morning to all of you here assembled here. Welcome to this presentation. The Elizarov Miracles in Skeletal Biology. The Magic of Elizarov Philosophy from Kurgan to Bangladesh. Here is the Kurgan Scientific Center in Russia. Here is our beloved NITOR. Elizarov technique is a revolutionary concept in the arena of orthopedics, by which bone can be made to grow even after skeletal maturity. The Elizarov system produces miracles, not only bones, but nerves, vessels, tendons, muscles, ligaments, fascia, and even skin can be made possible to grow. This technique was developed in the former Soviet Union in the early 1951 by Gavriil Abrahamovich Elizarov, the legendary orthopedic surgeon from magician from Kurgan, Russia, to stimulate limb lengthening, correct mal-aligned appendicular skeletal deformities, heal non-unions, and close soft tissue defect. See, here is a car used by Gavriil Elizarov himself. It is located in the Kurgan premises. And another one is a dog with Elizarov in situ in the dog square of Kurgan, Russia. And another picture on the right top is the bicycle. It is wise saying that Elizarov invented this technique on the basis of stress and tension, stress theorem. And it is based on the circular dynamics of the spokes of the wheel. The versatile development of the method of Elizarov has considerably improved the quality of life for millions of patients around the globe. In Elizarov method, laws of tension, stress, and destruction osteogenesis, followed by mechanical induction of new bone formation and new vascularization resulting in activation and recruitment of osteoprogenitor cells, enigmatize the skeletal biology. See, Elizarov's law, or the law of tension stress, which formulates the general biological principles of the tissue's response to destruction, has been engraved on the pedestal of the monument of the genius of orthopedics. No doubt, the fact remains that compression destruction methods opens a new era instead of using traditional methods of surgical interventions. In Bangladesh, this method becomes popularized in early 19th decade. Needless to say, visiting an honored professor of the Elizarov Scientific Center, Kurgan, Russia, Professor Mofakrul Barisar, my mentor, devoted his life to promote the Elizarov method, not only in Bangladesh, but throughout the globe. His activities advanced the method in our country and salvaged limbs of thousands of people from amputations as well. Still, limited number of orthopedic surgeons gathered knowledge in Elizarov and treated patients with the magic of Elizarov in their day-to-day practice. In our country, orthopedic surgeons invariably face some terrible situations like open fractures, open fracture with bone loss, post-operative or post-traumatic osteomyelitis with implant in situ, and chronic osteomyelitis. For all these cases, there is no answer but Elizarov. It is mentionable that no myths or stories remain about the dissemination of Elizarov method from Kurgan, Russia, to our beloved Bangladesh. No doubt, Professor V.I. Shevshop and Professor Alexander Gubin from Kurgan Center, Russia, and Professor M.M. Bari, President Ashami Bangladesh Chapter, and Professor Abdul Ghani Mullah, Secretary Ashami Bangladesh, Director NITOR, and President of our Bangladesh Orthopedic Society from Bangladesh side, played the pivotal role in sending some orthopedic surgeons of Bangladesh to obtain fellowship training from Kurgan Center, Russia. And no doubt I feel proud during my visit in Kurgan, Russia, when my mentor's picture with profile is written and depicted in the books, and it was hung on the wall. It's pride, no doubt. Nowadays, needless to say that Elizarov, the method of transosseous osteosynthesis, has been philosophically and titanically popularized all over the country. This is the Professor Gabriel Elizarov's hospital chamber in Kurgan. So take-home message: the field of orthopedics is full of turning points or avenues where Elizarov heralds a new era in patient care. Elizarov is never a fix and forget surgery. It needs constant refining, fine-tuning, or adjustmental orchestra as well. Understanding of Elizarov biomechanics deserves the prime importance. It is not a must to go to Kurgan to be an Elizarov surgeon, though the name Kurgan comes always as the pioneer center of Elizarov surgery in the world. So thank you very much for the patient hearing.
Thank you very much. Now it's time for question and answer session. Is there any question regarding this presentation? This is a complimentary presentation, we all know that, historical presentation. And so I would like to go forward for the next presentation.
Thank you very much.
One question there.
Thank you, Arun Kumar. My question is, What is the difference, the Kurgan center and our center?
Well, it's a very good question, but it depends on many factors, actually. Actually, Kurgan is a specialized center for Elizarov methods, and Nidaur is multi-specialized. It is not only for the Elizarov procedures. All procedures, all subspecialties are working here. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your...
Sir, actually, in Kurgan, Elizarov, not only for the trauma or non-union, gap non-union, or any deformity correction, they are always they are all practicing for spine Elizarov also, spine. And there are some divisions of Elizarov also practice there. Thank you, sir.
Doctor, I have asked a very pertinent question. What is going on around the world? You see, when in 1994, I was in a year trauma basic training course in Singapore. Then I asked the chairman, Professor Shanskar, sir, what about the Elizarov, the same technique? Because the AO has the same theory that maintain the biology, maintain the stability, then you will have the good reunion. So what is the difference between? Because the Elizarov has already said, well, I was there in India with training, and I got the training in India. So he said, no. We don't know what is Elizarov, who is Elizarov, why it is happening. You see, that is the answer from the gentleman I still remember, Shanskar. But when, after within a few years, the thing has been changed because it has been its own originality, and it has been proved that for third world country, not only third world country, even the rich country, they have been also applying this method. That is the question, that they have got the beautiful research center. Elizarov himself, a researcher, he's a scientist to the highest point. He's a magnificent man with his own tuning and made that thing so nicely. All over the world, it has been accepted when in New York, in even Italy, in different places, that this is the Elizarov. This technique is not man, it is the technique. And that technique, not only one day, from 1950 onward, I think, he is doing consistently. And his team and research is going on side by side. So it has been proved that today the research. We are doing it, not no research, no paper, no collection. That's what we are lacking. But they have been in that sense, but I have also visited. They are doing so much research, and they have proved that this is one of the wonderful method to do for the benefit of the human being. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your experience. We think that they are doing the research and we are doing the operations. So we need a combination of that research and operations also. Now, I would like to request our next presenter. That is Dr. G. A. Munir. And the topic is Elizarov External Fixator Aided Soft Tissue Reconstruction is a useful tool for severe soft tissue trauma. Dr. G. A. Munir. Our Honorable Director of NITOR, Professor Abdul Ghani Molla sir, as well as the President of Bangladesh Orthopedic Society and the Secretary of ASAMI has joined with us. We are very grateful to our Honorable Professor, Director, Dr. Abdul Ghani Molla sir. Now I would like to request Dr. G. A. Munir sir to start his presentation.
Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. I am Dr. G. A. Munir from Kushtia Medical College. Here I am present for presenting in 9th ASAMI Bangladesh International Conference 2021. extensive injury in his right leg with tibia and fibula fracture. It was fixated by external fixator other than our Kushta Medical College. Then when he came to our college, then we applied Elizabeth fixation, and finally the patient is walking. Third case, you see there is extensive injury in the medial aspect of the right knee and lower third of the thigh. We applied external fixation, and it was easy for handling and dressing daily. And after skin grafting, the patient was like this. Fourth case, there was wound in the lateral aspect of the left leg, and after application of the Elizarop, and the wound is like this. And this patient was done skin grafting after wound healing, and patient is now okay. It's also a boy. He has extensive injury in his right foot and ankle, and after this the patient is like this, and after recovery his foot is nice. You can see a wound in the heel, which was treated by Elizab, and we did application of the Elizab ring and extensive dressing, and finally the foot is like this. These are some examples of the wound and application of Elizab. There are wounds, and we have applied Elizab ring. This is also, and the third case also. Results: postoperative dressings are very easy with this application of Elizab external fixator. Patient positioning also comfortable. Soft tissue recovery of all the patients are uneventful. Now the complication conclusion, that is rational application of Elizab external fixator in soft tissue reconstruction enhances soft tissue regeneration and decreases patient morbidity. Thank you all.
Thank you, Dr. G. M. Munir, for your excellent presentation. Is there any question? Now it is open for the question and answer session. Yeah, please. Do you have any question? Yeah. Please. Microphone, please.
You have shown the different type of substitutions of volume. Although we can do all this operation with internal access also, then why we apply this area?
In lower limb, you can see that if you fix a unilateral fixator, then the patient positioning is not easy. Sometimes if the wound is on the back side, then how you will keep the patient in his bed? It will the wound will stuck over the bed, and healing will not be easy. But in Elizab fixation, the wound will be over the fixator, and there is a gap between the bed and the wound, and it is easy to healing of the soft tissue. Thank you.
Sir.
Difference between
train for the young doctors. What is the result? For postgraduate degree, the axial fixator and multi-axial fixator. There is lots of difference between these two. In Lizarov effect, what is, you must keep it in your mind, effect of the Lizarov. Slow and steady traction on a living tissue creates a stress which is metabolically activated in biosynthetic and proliferative process, and which gives neovascularization in dermatogenesis, neurogenesis, myogenesis, histogenesis, osteogenesis, all genesis. But uniaxial fixator, you cannot get that. You cannot get that one. This is the beauty of Lizarov. And on the basis of that, I am telling you that while you are getting angiogenesis, at present I am working in the diabetic hospital. I am treating all the diabetic folks and peripheral vascular diseases by Lizarov technique. Before that, all these general surgeons, they are going for only amputation, amputation. When you are getting angiogenesis by Lizarov technique, by doing osteotomy and gradual traction gives new vascularization, that is the beauty of Lizarov. This is the difference between the uniaxial fixator and the multiaxial fixator.
Thank you, sir.
Standard flap or the flap delay. That is the myoclonus flap. Flap, in that case, we can give the external fixator uniaxial or biaxial. In multiaxial, there is a problem because when you give the flap, or you need the sural island flap or the soleus flap, or and in, there is a problem of the, that is the meticulous dressing also. In that case, you selected the case, and also I think Dr. Munir has done a wonderful job because he's the Lizarov surgeon, and that is the why he apply all the cases in the case by Lizarov. But if you see that. One and a half months, then you give up. No problem, because we have done it for long time.
Recording stopped. we have started our normal daily activity of the treatment beside the corona period, and we have 600 patient 600 to 800 patient admitted in a day in Kushtia Medical College. And it is a recap of the history. And me and Dr. Rashid Hassan, Rashid Hassan is also a EC member of Bangladesh Pediatric Orthopedic Society. And we started this with a just a printed paper from our hospital office, Elizarov Clinic, from 12 p.m. to 2 p.m. in every Wednesday. And it was a Facebook post. I cut it from there. And now we are more organized. Nowadays, we are in every Wednesday, we used to get 30 patients from that most of the cases treated in our hospital. And also we get some referral cases from outside different districts and also get some cases from NITOD that come to our center for the follow-up is a continuation treatment of the NITOD. And this is our, in a very limited manner, Elizarov Clinic and our dedicated team. And for proper outcome in Elizarov, everybody, you will admit that the proper communication between the doctors, patient, and the hospital staff is a must. And for Elizarov Clinic in Kushtia Medical College, we have a dedicated online, dedicated mobile service for 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. And we run this by two person. They are advising the patient and when they are coming, when they are not to come, and other things. And every day, 30 patients. If we calculate all that, we have a very good patient database. And around 1,200 patients we have served in the last year in almost 40 to 50 OPD days. And what are the operation we have done in our center? That in last 3 years, preferably I want to tell this is not 3 years, it's 2 years. Because in corona, when the most of the things are closed down, the better it is calculate the time in 2019 to 2021, the 2 years. We have operated more than 300 cases. The tibial open fracture, closed fracture, infected non-union cases, femur, humerus, radius ulna, and Elizarov aided soft tissue reconstruction that you have enjoyed the last session by Dr. G.M. Munir. And also we are doing the deformity correction and other cases. And the Parthes disease, we are doing Parthes disease in our center. And you know that in Parthes disease, the to increase the vascularity and the offloading of the lateral pillar and arthrodiastasis, we are doing head neck tunneling by Elizarov system, by multiple KORs and by the Shanzi screw in the pelvis, and arthrodiastasis, that is destruction of the hip joint. And severe deformity correction. And this is a medical student, and he has the at most 20 years old deformity, right? The foot is 90 degree aligned with the existing extremity and 3 inch shortest. And me and Dr. Munir were the team in these cases, and we performed the deformity correction, and the foot frame also applied then. And gradually the deformity is corrected. And then the next issue is the correction of the shortening. We do a corticotomy and lengthening. And now the patient, I just took this patient picture yesterday from patient resident. Residents, the almost the LLD is corrected and foot is almost corrected, but there is some form of varus. We may need some osteotomy in the later age. And this is one of the interesting cases that we have doing in Kushtia Medical College. This is a metabolic bone disease, and we worked up very hardly for the patient, and we sent the patient for metabolic workup in BSMU, but they did not conclude any specific diagnosis. But we labeled it as metabolic. The Winship deformity, this is also a very favorite case for my professor Mofakkar Bari. He used to love these cases to do correction. and this is preoperative film and correction doing, and the most severe part of the left side of the patient, and it was almost corrected, and there are some varus deformity on the right side. We will correct in the later on, and I have the video. I don't know whether this will active or not. Okay, let's try. It is a little bit distorted, but don't mind. And in other cases, the patient is walking with the frame. And now we are doing foot deformity cases, post-traumatic syndromic foot and the neglected club foot. Though you know that successful club foot program, the neglected club foot is now very rare. But syndromic foot, we can get some neuropathy causes and some hemangiomatosis cases. We have operated and corrected the deformity. This is a deformity of a 25 years old male patient and with a severe childhood infection and contracture. He developed this very bad equinus, and we corrected by application of the ileus, only the percutaneous stenotomy and nothing else, the other bony procedure. And patient have the nice plantigrade foot, and also the joint space and the radiology correction is very good there. And we have a very dedicated physiotherapy team, and with physiotherapy team we are giving the physiotherapy. This patient is treated in Nitor and getting physiotherapy for his limb lengthening in our center. And also in many patients, we are very much concerned about the subtalar joint movement. You know that when you apply the Ilizarov, there may be compromised subtalar movement. And patient register. We have a red book for patient register. We mentioned all the patient phone number. Sometimes we call personally the patient, and all the patient are documented in our center. And our future project, OrthoApps.
only. Since 82, I am doing it alone. Since 82, think about it. Still, I don't know a lot of things. So, very big subject is alone. Kurgan Center, that was the biggest orthopedic center that they call the orthopedic capital. Now they have 855 beds, our retail is 1,000 beds. Difference is, I'm already discussed for a thing. Amar kokte bolta holo, je Kurgan Center, Asho Panchanna, Peter Hospital, 350 reserve surgery. Bangladesh Lokshoka 18 koti, ওদের 14.5 কোটি হল রাশিয়া রাশিয়া 112 গুণ বড় বাংলাদেশ ছিল ওদের যদি এত ইলজাম সার্জন হতে পারে ভাই নবীন বাংলাদেশ আই মাস্ট কংগ্রেচুলেট আরিফ যে আউটসাইড ঢাকা হি হ্যাজ অলরেডি ক্রিয়েটেড এ ইন গভর্নমেন্ট মেডিকেল কলেজ ইনক্লুডিং দ্য পেডিয়াট্রিক ওয়ার্ডস সো আমার মেসেজ হলো আপনারা আপনারা যারা আছেন প্লিজ লার্ন ইট ইজার আপনি টু ফ্রেন্ড লেটার দিতে পৌঁছাটা Mojati, and how we can salvage the limb by doing the exam. Only the principle and philosophy should have to know. I must congratulate Ali Balisti for doing a very good job in Kostia outside. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
It's a really wonderful job you have done. Fantastic, Pastor. Because the most important thing is that they have the documentation. Documentation যদি না হয় আমি যাই কিছু করি না কেন কোনো কাজে লাগবে না এই যে উনি একটা মেডিকেল কলেজে অফেন্সিভ ভাবে এটা কলেজে কত কঠিন এটা দ্বারা আমরা কাজ করি গভর্নমেন্ট সাথে কাজ করে বছর কিছু করতে পারি প্রাইভেট সেক্টরে আমি চেষ্টা করেছি আমার যতগুলো জয়েন্ট রিপ্লেস করে সবগুলোকে ঢুকাই দিতে কম্পিউটার কিন্তু গভর্নমেন্ট সাথে করা ফলো আপ করা চুটটা চুটটা অ্যাপ করেছে যেটা বহু বছর আগে ইন্ডিয়াতে আমি বন্ধকে উনি ওইভাবে অ্যাপ করে ডকুমেন্ট করে দিয়ে তারা ওই রোগীদের সঙ্গে যোগাযোগ করতে জাস্ট জাস্ট কমিউনিকেশন হতে পারে বিকজ দ্য এভরিথিং রেকর্ডেড ইন দি ইন দ্য কম্পিউটার তো আজকে আরিফের এই ঢাকা মানে এরিয়াতে কুষ্টিয়া মেডিকেল কলেজ থেকে সব প্রেজেন্টেশন দেখলাম যেভাবে তারা এগোচ্ছে আমাদের সবার জন্য আই অপরিডি আমাদের সবাইকে এভাবে ভাবতে হবে চিন্তা করতে হবে থ্যাংক ইউ প্রফেসর আরি এইসব
অনেক আছে কনজিলিটার প্রস্টোমাটি বিগ গ্যাপ নন ইউনিয়ন ডিলেড ইউনিয়ন ইলিজারো এনি কাইন্ডস অফ ডিফর্মিটি কন্ট্রাকচার বোন এন্ড জয়েন্ট সফট টিস্যু ইনফেকশন and osteomyelitis with peripheral vascular disease are roilo ki orthopedics e ar ki roilo this is ilizaro not that only putting the words you must know the principle and the philosophy I'm bar bar keno boli I have seen what they are doing and I'm doing in my life earning lot of money by ilizaro only ilizaro you can help the poor people and what they are doing in kurga in kustia in my mindset And I may be in Sylhet. We have a lot of centers students are doing. They are coming. Please do. Please learn. You got help.
I must congratulate Dr. Ali. I mean, I didn't think that the past year that I was in the middle of the post-graduation process. Really, these many scriptures. She had a good job. She had a good job. She had a good job. She had a center to develop. Really, our shortcuts. Limitation to get some of the knowledge. She really appreciation আমি একটা জিনিস স্যার বলেছে যে একটা অ্যাপ তৈরি করছে আর একটা জিনিস চিন্তা করেছেন আমার এখানে আমি নিকটে থেকে আই ফিল দ্যাট ইন মাই ইউনিট উই নো মেনি রিজার্ভ বাট দি ডিফিকাল্টি ইজ দ্যাট দ্য ফলো আপ অফ দ্য কেসেস ওয়েন দ্য কেসেস কামস ফর আউটডোর উই ক্যান নট সি অ্যান্ড ক্যান নট ফলো আপ ডিউ টু দ্য ফলো আপ প্রপার ফলো আপ দ্য কেস সামটাইমস নট পে ও কিন্তু খুব সুন্দর যে ডেভেলপ করছে ও একটা টেলিফোন নাম্বার দিয়েছে ডেডিকেটেড টেলিফোন নাম্বার মোবাইল নাম্বার যেখানে রোগীরা নিজে ফোন করে এসে তারা নিজেরা সাথে যোগাযোগ করতে পারে আমার মনে হয় এটা আমাদের জন্য একটা শিক্ষণীয় মোটামুটি রিজার্ভ যদি আমরা করি রিজার্ভে পেশেন্ট বলছি নিয়মিত তার ফলো না করা হয় পেশেন্টের যদি এডুকেশন না দেওয়া হয় তাদের এক্সারসাইজ ল্যাঙ্গানি কম্প্রেশন ইত্যাদি এগুলো যদি না শেখানো হয় তাহলে কিন্তু আমরা পেয়ে যাবো এটা একটা ভালো জিনিস ভালো উদ্যোগ
Thank you, sir. Now I would like to request our honorable director, sir, and the secretary of Assami to say something.
Thank you, sir. We feel very much proud and encouraged by hearing the nice words from the most legendary professors in Bangladesh. Thank you, sir, and welcome you all to Kustia. Have a visit and see what we are doing there. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mohammad Arman. Hope the Kustia will be Kurgan of Bangladesh. And now I would like to request Dr. Mirajuddin Mullah for his presentation, and the topic is cosmetic lower limb lengthening by Elizarov arthritis, a short stature overcoming procedure. Dr. Mirajuddin Mullah.
Assalamu alaikum, good morning. I am Dr. Mohammad Mirajuddin Mullah, consultant orthopedic surgery. Presenting my paper, cosmetic limb lengthening with laser short stature. Popular in other countries earlier, but in Bangladesh it is a bit slow. Professor Mufakir Urbani has started this very early in Bangladesh, but still it is the patients are This man has made it possible with his unique theory and apparatus. Without him, the destruction of osteogenesis and bone lengthening was not possible. And without his device, without it was also not easy earlier. But nowadays, there are other options also. Usually adult height are determined by mainly by genetic and hereditary factors. Race, ethnic origins are the main factor, but due to other diseases and hormonal factors, height may not get their adequate height. So these are the factors, but usually people come to us for surgery, seeking surgery for due to professional factors. In some professions, there are a certain height limit, like in defense, in sports, actors, diving. Otherwise, those professions cannot be done. So they need a certain height for these professions. They seek the surgery. Social factors are also responsible. Some people find it difficult to bear that all of their known surroundings are taller, so they want to be taller. Aesthetic factors also. Some people simply want to gain height for look them beautiful. In Bangladesh, this surgery is not new, but still some people don't believe that this surgery should be done. Doctors of other specialty, even some orthopedic surgeons, have doubt this surgery. I am practicing this Elizabeth surgery for the last 11 years. Have lengthened more than 2,000 bones, but only increased height of two patients for sole cosmetic purpose. But every week, patients come for lengthening, discuss and then disappear. Preoperative assessment should be done thoroughly. The patient should be highly motivated and determined before undergoing this surgery. Because if they are not highly motivated, they can lose hope at the midpoint of the treatment, and you have complication. If patient is not self-motivated, his guardian should also be counseled prior to surgery. Physical assessment should be done for any metabolic disease. The lower leg and thigh ratio should be maintained. The leg should never be longer than the thigh. If the desired length is more than 3 inches, then both tibia and femur may need to be lengthened. Otherwise, only tibia lengthening is sufficient for lengthening. Some exercises are advised earlier in the preoperative period, so that later on he may get rehabilitated earlier. Calcium, vitamin D, C supplement should be started prior to surgery. The surgical technique is simple. A simple threading construct is used. Proximally, a 5-inch ring should be used to have full flexion of knee. Ring is assembled at mid-valgus and procrovertebral positions. After corticotomy, it is fitted at varus and decurvatum positions. Because there is a tendency to go into valgus and decurvatum and procrovertebral during the procedure. So to prevent this, we have to fix it as a varus and decurvatum position. An oblique corticotomy is preferred for regenerative formation, better regenerative formation. A unifocal corticotomy is done for 3 inches lengthening. We can do also bifocal corticotomy to save the time. Osteotomy of fibula done at lower level. Proximal and distal ring must hold fibula, otherwise it will deform the joints. For only tibia lengthening, both leg operated at the same time. And for tibia and femur, if we plan, then contralateral bones should be lengthened. Just the simple procedure. The postoperative care is important. Patient is encouraged to stand and walk on the first postoperative day with the help of walker. Ankle knee mobilization should be started earlier. Ankle should be protected from plantar flexion, and knee should be protected from flexion contraction. Otherwise, it will end up with equinus and flexion. Inside care is taught. Destruction is started from 10 to 14 days. Date of destruction depends on pain, tolerance, and amount of regenerative formation. Usually from 0.5 to 2 mm per day as tolerated by the patient. And follow-up should be done twice a month. Duration of wearing the rings, it takes 1 month to gain 1 inch in length, and then another 2 months for consolidation of the callus. So patient has to keep the rings in situ for 3 months to gain 1 inch. And for 3 inch, on an average, it takes 9 months. But for younger people, it can be removed earlier. Sometimes accordion maneuver used to strengthen the callus earlier. And there is another procedure we can insert intracranial nail after lengthening procedure. And in that way, we can also reduce the ring-wearing time. The removal of the ring depends on adequate clinical ability to bear full weight on one leg. Dynamization is done with prayer to remove the ring, and if he passes, then ring can be removed. And after removal, usually no cast or bracing was done. Only advised to use crutches for 1 month, and vigorous exercises can be started after 1 month. This is one case. This boy is from Bogura, and he just passed his school, and but he was 18, full mature. And he wanted to utilize his this corona period to gain 3 inches length. So he started. He was 5'3". He wants to be 5'6". So he did the body. You can see. So you can see the obliquity of the corticotomy. It is a long oblique corticotomy, so that early callus was should appear. So this is just after the day of surgery. He has started walking with the walker, and this this is for ankle protection. You should it should restrict the plantar flexion. And this is after lengthening of about 2 inches. He is walking with crutches. And you can see the amount of regeneration now. The already degenerate appeared, and this is the full after consolidation of the degenerate. So he was shorter than his father earlier, but after lengthening, he became taller than his father. This was his early picture, and this is his new picture. Not only that, he gained the length, but also the appearance also changed. His shoulder became broader, his hair became coarse, and now this look at the confidence of the patient. This is another patient. He was a professional cricket player. He is a fast bowler. He requires 5.6 inches for to become qualified for the fast bowler, but he was 5'3". So he wanted 3 inches to lengthen. So we did the surgery. This is how he was walking. This probably after he gained his 3 inches length, because he was shorter than this person, his relative. And in this patient, the also because corticotomy was done, but a bit short of the. And this is after consolidation and removal. And this is my assistant. He was equal to my assistant before surgery, and after surgery he got this length. He also sent a video from showing his activity level. He already returned to his sports activity. So most of us were worried that after his job surgery, will I be able to squat fully? So this patient can pray and sit fully. complication, there was no long-term complications. Temporary ankle stiffness developed and it was managed accordingly. Might be pintat infection was there, but no neurovascular complication encountered. Patient satisfaction, both of them are very much glad to gain height. They have utilized this corona lockdown period to gain height, so they did not miss their classes or training. The cricket player started playing cricket. So cosmetic limb length is already popular in developed countries, but in our country, intermittent and lengthening nails are not available, so it is less popular. Some people think silicone will cause them pain. But what we can do, we can lengthen the with reserve and insert the nail after lengthening, or do a lengthening of one nail procedure to shorten the ring wiring time. But the expense will increase after according to the number of the surgeries. So with only reserve, it is cheaper. It is a safe surgery, safe and I think. Thank you for your kind attention.
Thank you very much. Really, that was an excellent presentation and in a very presentation also. Before going to the question and answer session, I would like to do a question to Dr. Miraj Molla, sir. Why do you do the long oblique or short oblique corticotomy there? Is there any benefit there?
Yes, there is a difference between oblique osteotomy and transverse osteotomy, transverse corticotomy. In oblique corticotomy, the surface area of the regenerative formation is larger. So the callus appears earlier and also consolidates earlier. That's why long oblique osteotomy was done.
Is there any peroneal nerve injury?
There is every chance of common peroneal nerve injury during the surgery, during corticotomy, and after dissection. But you have to follow up accordingly. You have to see the sensation of the common peroneal nerve and motor activity every time the patient comes. If there is some neuropraxia or sensory deficiency or motor deficiency, then you have to slow the dissection rate.
Thank you very much. Now the floor is open for all, and I would like to request our honorable director, sir, regarding the presentation of Miraj Molla, sir. Is there any questions, sir?
Thank you, Miraj, for your cosmetic. One from our experience and from the book and from our mentors, like Professor Amjad Hussain and Professor Pari sir, that in cosmetic purpose, the extraction will be started after 14 days. You see from your ear.
No, extraction, right. 10 to 14
10
days.
10 to 14 days. If you wait 14 days, you get 14 days. So actually, when you have done the corticotomy, bone extraction will be started as soon as possible, particularly from the book 72.
Yes. Usually it helps to the follow-up, people the follow-up schedule, because we usually do the because we remove the stitch at 14 days. I usually tell the patient to come at 14 days and then teach him how to end the bone. It is easy to maintain the follow-up schedule with 14 days, because if we tell the patient to come after 14 days for stitch removal and then teach him how to distract, it is easier for the patient. That's why sometimes I like 14 days. Otherwise, we can start from 10 days.
Thank you very much.
My question is, Professor Barisar, and also with Miraj Molla. When we are doing the procedure, it is a bilateral procedure with the lengthening goes simultaneously. If there is instanted or not in the simultaneous process, that is one limb in the short and one limb in the normal position. What is the, if you face this kind of consequence?
No, the patient usually tolerates the same amount of distraction in both legs, so usually this is not first. If one patient lags behind like 1 centimeter or 2 centimeter, it can be recovered after some days when the pain is tolerated. It is not a big issue, I think.
Also,
No, it is not always in the cancellous bone. Corticotomy should not always done in the cancellous bone because you have to get some amount of cortex. Otherwise, it is not termed as corticotomy. You usually do it in the corticomedullary junction. So when we started in the corticomedullary junction and it's slanted backwards in the cortex, it does not hamper the formation of regenerate. But we should do the corticotomy at the corticomedullary junction. Start it from there.
Thank you very much. Now I'd like to request
Salihin, working as the assistant professor and head ortho oncology unit, National Institute of Cancer Research and Hospital. And I feel honored to present my paper in this auditorium and in front of the legion orthopedic surgeon, my teachers of Bangladesh. My topic is limb salvage for malignant bone tumor by Elizarov. And this is my institute, National Institute of Cancer Research and Hospital. It is 500-bedded hospital, but running on manpower is 300-bedded. And ortho-oncology unit was running established in this year. It is a 9-bedded unit, and manpower is only 3. I was assistant professor and my two assistant register and medical officer. And OPD service is running in 4 days from Saturday to Tuesday, and OT is only single day in a week, Thursday. And now come to the presentation. The bone sarcoma, tumors of pituitary mesenchymal origin, account for nearly 21% of all pediatric solid malignant cancers, and less than 1% of adult solid malignant cancers. The most common site for both bone and soft tissue sarcoma was within the extremities. That is 23% of soft tissue sarcoma and 52% of bone sarcoma. Amputation have been the standard methods of treatment for most bone sarcomas, but 1980s witnessed the development of the limb sparing surgery for most malignant bone tumors. Today, limb saving surgery is considered as a safe and routine for approximately 90% of the patient with extremity malignant bone tumors. So what is limb salvage surgery? It is a set of surgical techniques that have been developed to restore the skeletal continuity following in-block resection of the bone and soft tissue neoplasm. The goal of the limb salvage surgery is painless limb and functional tumor-free limb. So what are the criteria for limb sparing surgery in malignant bone tumor? The first number one criteria is tumor resection occurs with oncologically sound margins, and reconstruction leads to a functional limb, and all soft tissue defects can be closed primarily or with soft tissue transfer. So there are 3 stages for limb salvage surgery in case of malignant bone tumor. First stage is tumor resection. This is the principle of surgical oncology. And second stage is stable, painless skeletal reconstruction. That is the principle of orthopedic surgery. And third stage is surrounding and supporting soft tissue reconstruction. That is the principle of plastic surgery. So reconstruction of the bone can be done by 2 methods. One is non-biological option, and another one is biological options. The non-biological options are endoprosthesis, allograft prosthetic composite, resection arthrodesis. And biological reconstruction methods are non-vascularized graft, vascularized graft, allograft, recycled bone, and rotational plastic. So this is the, as a whole, principle of the surgical resection and reconstruction of malignant bone tumor. At least 3 cm healthy bony margin should be excised. 1 healthy muscle margin should be excised. Barrier-like physis pediastem thick fascia should be excised. And focally closed marginal excision can be done in case of neurovascular bundle. So for doing a limb salvage surgery, we first do the diagnosis. First do a clinical examination and then the radiological investigation. X-ray and MRI is the basic investigation for doing the limb salvage surgery. And sometimes CT scan of the done in case of inaccessible site like the pelvis. And the next step is biopsy. Do not do any cytology or FNAC or CT guided FNAC, because we can do core biopsy or jump CT bone mineral biopsy in a short period of time. And tissue after getting tissue diagnosis, first treatment should be started. And the next step is the staging. The staging is the investigations are CT chest and preferably PET CT scan. And the next step is the management, and management has various components, chemotherapy, radiation therapy, and surgery. So for doing the limb salvage surgery in case of malignant bone tumor, multidisciplinary team approach is essential. The team members are orthopedic surgeon, radiologist, pathologist, oncologist, physiotherapist, occupational therapist, prosthetist, and rehabilitation nurses. So a successful limb salvage depends upon the following factors: early management and referral, multidisciplinary workup, early stage, good result, patient education, and good surgical resection and reconstruction. That is, R0 resection is mandatory for doing a limb salvage surgery. So for doing limb salvage surgery, in case of malignant bone tumor, tumor board is essential. The team members of the tumor boards are orthopedic oncosurgeon, medical oncologist, radiation oncologist, histopathologist, and radiologist. So what is the advantage of Eliezerov in bone malignancy? It is a beneficial for limb lengthening, arthrodesis using destruction osteogenesis, and fibula has been a versatile resource for reconstructing defect of up to 22 centimeters, which can be done by Eliezerov. And the disadvantage of Eliezerov in bone malignancy, because all patients are in neutropenic, because most of the patient got neoadjuvant chemotherapy. So there is a chance of PINTEC infection, or infection is a factor, skin necrosis and infection occur. There may be poor bone formation, there may be skin defect, pseudoarthrosis is also common, and angulation deformity can be done. So this is the literature I have reviewed in my series. There is a destruction osteogenesis and arthrodesis as a new surgical option for chondrosarcoma in distal tibia. This is another literature. They have done limb salvage surgery by Eliezerov, bone transport using Eliezerov method for osteosarcoma patient with tumor resection and neoadjuvant chemotherapy. And this is another journal, bones, limb salvage surgery, bone reconstruction was done by Eliezerov method. And the follow-up was performed by musculoskeletal tumor SO30 scoring system and ASHAMI scoring function scoring system. And now case illustration is a 16 years old girl presented with osteogenic sarcoma of the distal tibia with 4-cycle neoadjuvant chemotherapy. What will be our option? There is no prosthesis available in this aspect. And this is the MRI finding. And we have done wide local excision with thorough oncological principle of the distal tibia, and proximal corticotomy was performed. And then gradual destruction was done. And arthrodesis, 18 months after, this is X-ray, arthrodesis of the ankle joint was done. And this is the picture of the young lady, young girl. And this is another patient, 17 years old girl, is a diagnosed case of Jung sarcoma of the tibia. And patient got 8-cycle neoadjuvant chemotherapy. And this is the post-NACT X-ray. And this is a paraoperative image and postoperative X-ray. Look at the paraoperative image. This is the incision mark. We have excised the tumor along with the incision mark, and preoperative imaging was preoperative planning was performed by MRI, and wide local excision was done. And the gap, this is the gap, and gap is filled by transportation of the fibula. This is 8 months after surgery with chemotherapy is completed. and this is the 16 months after surgery. This is the X-ray, united, and removal of the Elizarov ring. And this is the a picture of 18 months after surgery. And these are 2 years after surgery. This is the X-ray. And patient is still alive, and there is no lung mets. This is another patient, 38 years old man, presented with malignant fibrous histiocytoma of the tibia. We have done two-stage operation. First of all, we excise the tumor, wide local excision of the tumor, wait for histopathology report for marginal clearance. When the histopathologist gave the all the dissection margin is free of tumor, and we have done this type of operation. This is a bifocal corticotomy. Bifocal corticotomy was done, and gap is filled by the new bone. And these are 5 months after surgery. These are images. And these are 8 months after surgery. And 8 months after surgery with bone transport with Elizarov, and patient is walking with Elizarov and waiting for consolidation and remove the ring. So my conclusion is biological reconstruction using Elizarov circular fixator should be considered safe and effective in the management of malignant tumors and salvage treatment in case of failure of the other methods of limb salvage. So my home message is limb sparing surgery or wide local excision is the technique of choice for primary bone sarcoma. In comparison to amputation, wide local excision with Elizarov has early return to function, higher patient satisfaction, same overall survival and local recurrence rate. So we must do R0 resection when we will do limb salvage for malignant bone tumors by Elizarov. And lastly, I respect my teacher, Professor Iqbal Kavi sir, my mentor, and by his inspiration, I'm now ortho-onco surgeon. And thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Salahin, for this nice presentation. May I ask some experience or comments from our senior teacher?
Siraj Salahin, sir, I enjoyed your presentation last in the Society of Surgeons meeting, where you have also presented very nicely. There was also a tremendous, and today we have also observed your presentation. You are really doing good job. Do you have any connection, I mean, out of the way, with these other people, those who are doing this, like Miles Vahanan from Chennai, he's our good friend. Do you have any connection of this, Tumor Society, Orthopedic Tumor Society?
No, sir. I have a connection with Manish Agarwal and Professor Reddy.
There is a committee. They are doing only this limb. Orthopedic Tumor Society. And I will.
Give I know. You I know, sir. You are the only Bangladeshi member in the society.
They have put me in the name, but as because I don't know who is doing here. So সেদিন তোমাকে খুঁজতে ছিলাম পরে. দেখো আমার মনে তুমি আমাকে একটু দয়া করে ফোন করো আমি তোমাকে কানেক্ট করে দেবো.
Thank you, sir.
সম্ভব না সব কিছু করা. তাই না? ঠিক আছে. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. তোমার ভালো প্রেজেন্টেশন.
Thank you very much, Shiraz Salim. Elizarov in the tumor again, see, why not? So this is also message. Benign, all the time we are using Elizarov in benign bone tumors, even in fibrous dysplasia. This malignant tumor, what he has shown fantastically, but I want to pass only one comment regarding the, you have removed the segment and that you told the bifocal, that is called the trifocal. When you are doing two-level corticotomy and your gap is, and you are transporting from below and from the up, and you are filling the middle one, that is called trifocal. Otherwise, he's doing very good job. Thank you very much from our Assami group. Thank you again. So continue your work.
Patients have the low hemoglobin percentage. In this case, bone transport is very difficult. Do you have any experience about this?
Minimum 10. I have to maintain the hemoglobin percentage minimum 10. And we always do follow up 3 months interval with CBC and chest x-ray and the local part x-ray.
Thank you.
Okay, Saleh. Thank you, Saleh, for taking interest in bone tumor, which is in fact neglected in our country. A very few surgeons has devoted interest in tumor surgeries. And many of us have been doing tumor surgeries for quite a long time. Alum Bhai and other people, all of you have been involved in the tumor surgery, but tumor surgery has changed a lot. So if you, somebody do not have special interest in that subject, it cannot be improved. So Salehin, thank you, and I'm very happy that you have done so many tumor surgeries. I have also listened to your other lectures as well, where you have shown the tumor in other areas as well. So in this lecture, you have mostly shown this peripheral limbs where this Ilizarov can be used. But in other areas, using Ilizarov is not difficult or not possible at all. But in periphery, in the limbs, Ilizarov is an excellent apparatus because you can bridge that amount of gap. He has shown in his slide, big gap, and that has been bridged by bifocal or trifocal, whatever we call. Logically, it seems to be bifocal because you have been transporting bone from 2 points. Forget about the other part. So logically, it should be bifocal rather than trifocal. Okay. So if you want to have a vote in here, so what should be the nomenclature? Is it a bifocal or trifocal? Will be difficult situation. So I do not want to go into that debate. Okay, whatever may be, the name may be, whatever bifocal or trifocal, that is an excellent example of bridging that amount of gap. So now many of us can do the Ilizarov system. It's familiar to many of you. So if you know the tumor surgery, doing surgery excision is not the main thing, but doing it rightly is really, really difficult. You need support of many people. I have a question to you. So you have shown a board, tumor board, which that is in existence in your team?
Yes, yes. In my private cases, I always maintain the tumor board by WhatsApp. And in our institute, in our institute, there is a tumor board. Every day, tumor board is occur, and after decision of the tumor board, we perform the surgery. And where the neoadjuvant chemotherapy is done, and where the surgery is do the first, the tumor board already give the decision.
Another person who does take this biopsy, 4 biopsies.
Unfortunately, 90% of the cases, biopsies have done outside from my institute. It's very unfortunate. Real problem, yes. Because right. Biopsy must be done by the operating surgeon because we should excise the tumor along with the biopsy tract. Otherwise, local recurrence is inevitable.
Thank you. Salim, very, very pleased to see you here. You are the only gladiator in this field fighting with the tumor. I appreciate you, your efforts. I have one question to you. How do you decide the tumor-free margin paraoperatively in cases of sarcoma or maybe aggressive bone tumor like giant cell tumor? How do you decide the free tumor-free margin during your operation?
Thank you very much. This is a very, very important and nice question. I have a planning before operation. No planning in paraoperative. Before operation, I have do the MRI. And by MRI, they give the margin of the tumor radiological. Radiologist is also a part of my tumor board. And he give the cut margin, mention the cut margin. And paraoperatively, I have mentioned frozen section biopsy. I have facilities I have taken in my institute and my private practice. And I have sent the specimen for frozen section. In case of bone, frozen section cannot be done paraoperatively. But I have sent the marrow. If they mention that marrow is free of tumor, so if operation is R0.
Thank you.
Another question. In case of leg tumor
in the tibia. Tibia is a subcutaneous bone. Okay. In your case, you have shown a Ewing's tumor. Ewing's tumor in the tibia. Okay. And you have excised with part of the skin and the bone. But tumor was quite big, which actually extended beyond the skin margin. The skin you have excised. Then how can we exclude a tumor-free margin in a leg bone? Do you understand?
Okay.
So okay, you have taken a skin of small part. If you really want to take whole skin and soft tissues, then you'll have to have a free graft to cover that area before transporting the bone. So in that situation, do you have any advice how we can avoid that problem?
In that case, I have done the frozen section biopsy, and when I send the specimen, they show the skin margin is free of tumor, and the periosteum, they take the periosteum from the bone, and the periosteum is also free of tumor. So when the periosteum is free of tumor, the skin is also free of tumor.
Thank you, Salihin, for your nice and lively presentation, lively discussion. And our next speaker is Kamarajan. Before that, our Janen, Jakari Ben Hamid. Amader Shraddho Ek Shikshok, senior member, Professor Shamim Adam sir, Ajker Shokal Intekal Korechen. Amra ei sessioner sheshe, onar jonno amra ek minute nirbata palon korbo. Uni Asamir live member silen. Executive member.
Dr. Jakaria bin Hamid, our presenter now. As because of we have time constraint, we have to maintain the time limitations there. We have other international faculties waiting for the presentation.
Jodi ready korte deri hoy amar mone hoy shomoyer obhabe amra ekhoni 1 minute nirbata palon korbo kina senior chhatro sir.
আমরা প্রফেসর শামীম আদম ওনার জানেন যে রাতে উনি মর্নিং এ উনি মারা গেছেন ইন্নালিল্লাহি ওয়া ইন্না ইলাইহি রাজিউন উনি আমাদের শ্রদ্ধা শিক্ষক ছিলেন বড় ভাই ছিলেন এবং এই সাবজেক্টে ডেডিকেটেড ছিলেন উনি লাস্টে কুমুদিনী মেডিকেল কলেজের প্রফেসর ছিলেন এবং নর্থ বেঙ্গল মেডিকেল কলেজের প্রফেসর ছিলেন উনি যে কোনো অপশনে আসতেন গতকালকে বারিসার সাথে কথা হয়েছে আমিও ট্রাই করেছিলাম পাইনি কিন্তু বারিসার সঙ্গে কথা হয়েছিল যে আজকে উনি সকালে আসবেন উনি আমাদের আসামের লাইভ মেম্বার ছিল অ্যাট দ্য সেম টাইম এক্সিকিউটিভ কমিটির আমাদের মেম্বার ছিলেন ওনার আত্মার শান্তির জন্য আমরা এক মিনিট ধন্যবাদ সকলকে।
আমি বেশি সময় দিব না, শুধু সংক্ষেপে একটু মনে করাটা ভালো হয়েছে মুসলিম আর যারা অন্যান্য ধর্মে আছে তারা করবেন। সুরা একলাস পড়ে তিনবার, বিসমিল্লাহ শহীদ আর দরুদ শরীফ পড়ে। আল্লাহুম্মা আমিন। يَا رَبِّ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ كَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِجَلَالِ وَجْهِكَ وَعَظِيمِ سُلْطَانِكَ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ بِالْإِيمَانِ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ لَكَ الْحَمْدُ بِالْقُرْآنِ اللَّهُمَّ إِنَّكَ عَلَى ذِكْرِكَ وَشُكْرِكَ وَعِبَادَتِكَ اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى تَقْوَاهَا زَكِّهَا أَنْتَ خَيْرُ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا اللَّهُمَّ اهْدِنَا فِيمَنْ هَدَيْتَ وَعَافِنَا فِيمَنْ عَافَيْتَ وتولنا في من توليت وقنا واصبرنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت اللهم لا تدع لنا دما في مكابن هذا إلا وفرت ولا دينا إلا قضيت ولا مريدا إلا شفيت ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا إلا فيتها يا الله يا الله আমাদের মাঝ থেকে আমাদের বড় ভাই সত্য স্বামী মাধব কালকে দুপুরে আমার সাথে কথা হয়েছে 12:30টায়, তারপর আমি বাড়ি গেছিলাম, ফোন করেছে যে আমি অবশ্যই আসবো, দেখেন আমাদের জীবনটা কেমন। এই দুনিয়া হলো মাতা ও হায়াতির দুনিয়া, ফণিকে কে কখন চলে যাবেন কেউ বলতে পারে না। আমরা আমাদের এই বড় ভাইয়ের জন্য দোয়া করি, যারা আমাদের আবার ডাক্তার যারা বন্ধু ছোট বড় যারা ছিলেন সবার জন্য দোয়া করি। আল্লাহ ওনাকে জান্নাত ও ফেরদাউস বেস্ট নসিব করুন। ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار। الله تعالى الله বলেছেন قل يا عبادي الذين اسرفوا على انفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله। আমার রহমত থেকে তোমরা নিরাশ হয়ো না। আমরা দোয়া করি আল্লাহ আমাদেরকে জান্নাতে প্রবেশ করুন, আমিন। নাও আই
উড লাইক টু রিকোয়েস্ট ডক্টর জাকারিয়া বিন হামিদ টু স্টার্ট হিজ প্রেজেন্টেশন।
Respected teachers and dear colleagues, assalamu alaikum. I welcome all of you in today's presentation. I am Dr. Mohammad Zakaria bin Hamid, MS resident phase B, NITOR. Today my topic is infected non-union fracture shaft of the humerus treated by Elizarov method. This is not only today's topic but also my thesis case I am doing in NITOR still now. Fracture humerus constitute about 3% of all fractures, and non-union occurs approximately 13% in treated operatively and 8% treated conservatively, and failure to union of the fracture within 6 to 8 months with persistent infection we called it infected non-union. Infected non-union management is still now challenging in our country. Most of these patients were repeatedly operated and failed to unite. Elizarov method is a great hope for this patient as it can eradicate infection, compensate bone defect, promote the bone union through progressive bone osteogenesis, and at the same time it correct the deformities and limb length discrepancies. We all know the common causes of non-union. These are the listed. The most important cause is infection, distraction at the fracture site, unstable fixation, iatrogenic devitalization of the soft tissue, bone loss, osteoporosis, etc. And the types of the non-union are, we know that there are two types, hypervascular and avascular, and hypervascular three types, avascular are non-union are four types. My thesis, materials and methods, number of the patient are 19, and from them male are 17 and female are 2. Mean age of the patient 39 years, place of operation in NITOR, and time September 2019 to ongoing. Modalities of the treatment of infected non-union are plating and bone grafting, exchange nailing, fibular start grafting, and Elizarov method. And in case of infected non-union, Elizarov method, at first, there is a previous operation, removal of the plates, screws or nail, then debridement, acute rocking, and then application of Elizarov external fixator. And bone graft was not used. Results, there are 14 cases are united and 5 cases are in progress of union. Infection control, 2 cases still have some elbow stiffness and 2 cases have 2 to 3 centimeter humeral shortening due to debridement. And pin tract infection and radial nerve palsy recovered after completion of treatment, and all patients are satisfied with the treatment. And in conclusion, Elizarov external fixator offered a reliable and successful method, not only for stabilization, satisfactory bone union and functional outcome, but also correcting limb length discrepancy and eradication of infection. So Elizarov method is the blessing for those who are frustrated for their infected non-union shaft of the humerus. Now I will show some of my case illustration. At first, Abdul Wadud, 40 years of old, patient came in Nitor in open fracture shaft of the humerus, gastrilo 3B. We did external fixator in emergency OT, and after control of infection, then we remove the external fixator and give Elizarov external fixator. And after that, bone union occurs. And after removal of the ring, this is the picture of the patient, extension and flexion. And this is the video of the patient movement. Another patient, Abdul Hannan, 35 years. Came with infected non-union, we do Elizarov external fixator and bone union occurs. And in this patient, there is some extension lag. But this patient is still in follow-up. Another patient, Aminul Islam, 35 years, closed fracture shaft of the humerus initially.
And some complication and management. Pin tract infection. In case of superficial pin tract infection, we won't care dressing, maintaining the protocol. But in case of deep infection, remove wire and replace in different site than present one. And anesthesia is for intolerable pain. And physiotherapy is very much important. Joint mobilization and muscle strengthening exercise. And this is the video. You see, the external fixator patient working with the aids, crutches, but nicely working with Elizarov external fixator. Now come to the removal of this fixator. When the X-ray shows at least three cortexes fully ossified with sharp outline of cortical bone out of four cortexes, and stress tests were performed for each patient for removing the frame, and the patient asked to limb in a functional manner, used to limb in a functional manner. Result, total patient 20, male 30 and female is 10, with mean age 28 years. Here is the initial mode of injury, root trafficking is 28, followed from height 8, and physical accessory is 4. And right tibia fibula is 28, whereas left tibia fibula involved in 12. And Gastrilo Anderson classification, Gastrilo 2 is 30% and 3 is 45% and 25% is Gastrilo 3B in our series. And mean interval between the initial trauma and Elizarov fixator application is 4.4 months. Union or sign of union achieved in all cases, average time is 17.12 weeks.
The eliezer of fixator was kept for average 195 days. And the minimum follow-up was 9 months after frame removal. You know the Assam scoring system. Here is 7 variables. We assess the patient by this scoring system. Based on Assam scoring system, bony and functional results were assessed. Here the bony outcome is excellent is 60%, good is 30%, and 10 is fair. But functional outcome is the 45% is excellent, 40 is good, 10 is fair, and 5 is poor. In this series, 16 patients, 20 were had pin track infection, and most pin track infection healed with the regular dressing and oral antibiotic, but 8 patients, 8 affected loose were exchanged. And none of our patients developed neurovascular complication related to unintended penetration of KOR. Discussion. We compared this study at the Singh et al. India to avoid repeated surgical intervention, to reduce the cost of patient, to reduce the suffering of the patient. Eliezer of multi-axial multiplanar system is the magic method for the management of non-uniting infected TBF fibula fracture. Home message. Every journey we have a lifeboat or life jacket, because last 2 to 3 days ago you see the fire accident in the lawns. So eliezer of method is the lifeboat technology for the orthopedic surgeon, because orthopedic surgeon are always in danger, especially working in the periphery. And it is the golden method for the management of the infected non-union, and for both achieving union as well as eradication of infection. Thank you. Thank you very much for patience hearing.
Thank you, Kamran Jaman. And last, this is the end of this session. And next, we will go to our TVEC. And a small comment from our senior teacher, former director. Sir.
Rather inquiry. In your presentation, you mentioned that 18,000 deaths in 1 year from rotor. Follow me?
Sir.
You mentioned that there was 18,000 deaths in a year followed by road traffic accidents. And road the injury,
16,000.
So was 17,000 or 16,000.
16,
you mentioned.
2018.
But we know that for every death, there are at least three major injuries. So in that calculation, if there is 18,000 deaths, it should be at least
8,000. 8,000 and 16,000 injured. No, sir. 8,000. 8,000. This is the data from the Jatri Paribahan Seva.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
And final comments, sir, from our senior teacher, former director, Sheikh Nur Alam, sir.
It's an interesting subject, later. Initially, the primary Shabai Amra Kote Patamna. এখন অনেক এক্সপার্টিজ ডেভেলপ করছে মেইন সার্জন তো আমাদের বাড়ি রয়ে গেছে কিন্তু আরো অনেক জুনিয়ররা আরো এগিয়ে গেছে এর জন্য আমার কাছে ভালো লাগছে মানে বিশেষ করে ইনফেক্টেড নন ইউনিয়ন করত আগে থেকে আর একটু আগে যে একটা প্রেজেন্টেশন হয়েছে বোন টিউমার এটার জন্য আমাদের খুবই সমস্যা ছিল আমাদের এন্ডোপ্রোসেসিস ছিল না শুধু আমরা অ্যাম্পুটেশন করতাম অথবা আর্থোডিসিস করতাম কিন্তু এখন আর্থোডিসিস করা লাগবে না হয়তো আর মেগা প্রস্থেসিস লাগবে যেহেতু এটা খুব কস্টলি এবং কমপ্লিকেশন পেশি এখন যদি লেজার অফ দিয়ে ইজি সলিউশনে আসা যাবে কিন্তু ওদের সাথে যারা আরো সার্জন যারা থাকে প্লাস্টিক সার্জন একটু ভালো লাগবে ওরা অনকোলজিস্টটা এখন রয়েছে তো অনকোলজি হাসপাতালই আছে এরকম একটা ইনস্টিটিউটে এটা একটা সেন্টার হতে পারে এটা একটা অবজারভেশন আমার আর হলো যে তোমাদের যে সাবজেক্ট এটা খুব ভালো
থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার আমি একটা জিনিস শেয়ার করার জন্য শুধু বলবো যে আমি একটা টার্ম এখানে ব্যবহার করেছি নন ইউনাইটিং বা ইউনাইটিং এই টার্মটা আসলে বইয়ে খুব একটা পাওয়া যায় না আমি রিজবিসারের কোটেশন দিয়ে এই টার্মটা আমাদের জার্নালে ব্যবহার করেছি কারণ হচ্ছে আমরা অনেক সময় নন ইউনিয়নের সংজ্ঞা বলতে যাই সারপ্রাই বলতেন যে 9 মাস পর্যন্ত কি অপেক্ষা করবা আমার যেহেতু 1 সেন্টিমিটারের মতো গ্যাপ অলরেডি তৈরি হয়ে গেছে 4 মাসে তখন আমি আর অপেক্ষা করতে পারি না সো এই টার্মটা আমরা অনারেবল রিজবি স্যারকে রেসপেক্ট করে বলছি, স্যারের কোটেশন দিয়ে আমি এই টার্মটাই জার্নালে ব্যবহার করছি। থ্যাংক ইউ স্যার, থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ।
স্যার বলতো ইউনাইটিং, নন ইউনিটিং বলা নেই।
Thank you very much, Dr. Kamruzzaman. Now it's time for tea break.
আমাদের ইনফ্যাক্ট ফরেন ডেলিগেটস অলরেডি তারা আমাদের 11:30 পর্যন্ত ইনগুরাল সেশন, 11:30-11:15 আমরা একটু লেট হয়ে গেছে, এখন 5 মিনিট বা 10 মিনিট টি ব্রেক, তারপরে শুরু করলে হয়, প্লিজ। টি ব্রেকে, টি ব্রেকটা কোন জায়গায় বলো না, ওই কর্নারে আছে বাম পাশে, যেটা সবসময় হয় আর কি, লেফট সাইডে, হ্যাঁ যেটা সবসময় হয়, একটু তাড়াতাড়ি প্লিজ আপনারা একটু তাড়াতাড়ি করেন, তাড়াতাড়ি আসবেন আবার হলে।
গুড মর্নিং, এক্সেলেন্ট এক্সেলেন্ট প্রফেসর মারি, Constantine.